Hello guys, and welcome to Melon Sugar Podcast. It's your host, as usual, Kedho, and I'm here with
Delali.
And seriously, it's so amazing as always to be with you guys and to just experience, share our thoughts with you guys and everywhere. I'd like to say a very big thank you to everyone listening and just subscribing, Charlie. You guys, we love you so much. And Delali, I think we owe our listeners an apology. So let's just make it quick. We are very, very sorry for the past 2 weeks. We haven't been able to maybe record or upload a show or anything. A whole lot happened. So I think you guys should just in your heart to just forgive us. So yeah, so Delali, say the last week was so kind of boring for me, but with everything that went on social media, seriously, it was so exaggerating. So today's episode, because I wanted us to discuss the addiction thing, but out of nowhere, I got that thing like, okay, let's discuss fetish, people's fetish. Someone has like, let me say, sexual fetish or something, and that came up with that. What made me want us to discuss this is with the Dubai potty portal or something. I think it was trending on social media. And upon seeing a lot of conversations about it, most people were like, ew. And I think one comment that a girl, I think she is a Nigerian, she commented was, it's not about you guys doing ew. It's someone's fetish. And most of the people in the comment section were just on hair. And I was like, okay, wait. If we say someone has a sexual fetish, what does it mean? Is it something so gross, or is it just something like having like an addiction to like to drugs, or is just like something like that maybe is, let me say, sorry to say, abnormal? What do you have to say about it?
So I think I'll take it from your last then the last word you used, abnormal. Fetishes, basically they are like people's sexual it's people's sexual things they do sexually that most of the times pleases daily. You understand? So exactly. So sometimes a person might have a fetish, and the fetish won't be pleasing to the other partner. You understand? It's something pleases just them. You understand? Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's the thing. With the latest comments, I don't really think the Dubai potty potter or whatever it is can be classified as a fetish. It's understandable that some people you know, may see that as someone's way of pleasing him or herself. However, when you look at it extensively, I don't think it is healthy. You understand? If it was healthy, then they would be doing it themselves. But a lot of times, people perform or practice their fetishes on themselves. You understand? Whenever there is a second party involved, then you would have to consider the other person's, you know, health and you know, other matters too.
Yeah.
So yeah, I don't think it can be classified as a fetish.
But what many people were trying to say was, I think with the older guys, with the Arabs and the whatsoever there, I think they have that kind of let me say, it's typical to like BDSM or something, but for them with the BDSM, their own is like making you look like they are slave or something and just making you feel like you are nobody. So for me, I find it very, very, very gross. I find it very, very stupid. But I don't want to like maybe just I don't want to like close my mind. I just want to be open-minded, because you might not know most of, maybe many of our listeners, some might have that kind of fetish. So I think for me, I won't say it's normal for me, but with seeing it, because I know this thing goes on. Seriously, you can't tell me you go to Dubai and you don't know. Most of our girls here are doing it to them. So they just take a trip to Dubai. And it happens. So for me, what on social media, what people were just trying to like act like they've just heard it or they've just seen it. No. It's like, and for me, the hypocritical thing was many of the older guys, if you check the comments, because one site that tweeted, and I was just, the comments, most of them were older guys commenting, who were just saying a lot of stupid things, but they didn't want to like take in whatever whatever the opposite side had. So they just took it like, oh, it's just their way of just maybe having that feel or something. So seriously, for me, dear, it's very, very gross. For me, I don't know about you, but let me say this. If you are giving, if you are giving like $1 million, will you do this?
Never. So you know, for me, this is not the first time I have actually heard of this. I have known this for a year or two now.
Yeah.
I remember it was in the same Twitter I channeled on it one time. I think some time passed like that. It didn't really blow out of proportion as it has now. Someone tweeted about it some time back like that. I think it's last year or last 2 years. So I have known, and then also I have watched videos of it, videos of stories concerning it on YouTube. So yes, it's nothing new.
So you know, with this whole issue,
So for me, I think this other thing is, you know, these Arabians have some level of disrespect for Westerners.
Yeah.
This is not even just blacks alone, because one story I saw was not in relation to a black. This was a Caucasian, and what happened was, she was sent a message on Instagram, you know, these Instagram models.
Yeah.
So when she was sent a message on Instagram, the man, you know, told her he wants to fly her over to Dubai. Then the lady asked how much the man would pay. Yeah. So the man said, I think $50 or something like that. And then, you know, so I think the lady went through the man's profile, and then, you know, timeline, went through the man's page or whatever, saw the man's assets, the cars and whatnot, the man had. And so the lady asked about the car, what's of this car. The man said, okay, if you want it, then you would have to do this. And then the lady was like, okay, she would do it. You get it? And yeah, for them, as I was saying, for them, they have this thing against Westerners. They feel, you know, of course, you know how these Arabians feel. They feel our way of them, the Westerners way of life isn't the right way. So every chance they get, they try to, you know, dehumanize you, make you feel less of a human. You get it? And why do you think they don't target their own people? When you look at the people who get involved in all these things are people who are from outside, or most of them are non-Muslims. Most of them are just Christians. You get it?
Yeah.
So it's a way of they lording themselves over these young ladies, and also to the Western culture as a whole. So yeah, basically, I think. Money makes people do stupid things. Money
very can make you do things very stupid.
You know things you've never thought of. But for me, I feel more for most of these were, you know, there are some women who didn't know, who were just unfortunate to have found themselves in such situations, and then there are those who are well aware of it. You know, they know before they even go there. They are briefed. They are aware that this is what we're going to do, and still do it for the money. You get it? And you know, it's quite sad because these things are nasty. Listen, they are gross. They are, you can't let another human being, a fellow human being, be eating your poop. Come on, it's sad. It's really sad. I find it strange. Honestly, I find it strange that people are now hearing about it, because this thing has been like, come on, it has been existing for only God knows how long. It has been there. This thing has been there for a long time. Most of these young ladies, you see them go to Dubai, they come back and they have, come on, they come back rich, and you start questioning, you start asking questions like, yo. And then Dubai, what exactly do you go there to do? Well, you know, because you can't just go there for a holiday trip for about a week or a few days, and then you come back with stacks of cash, dollars, and all that. You know, it's just sad. It's sad. It's really sad.
But for me, I think people knew. I think people have people had a knowledge about it, but with the videos and everything, like, being retweeted, being posted on Twitter, that has made a lot of people to be like, kind of like, whoa, so this thing goes on and everything. But I think most people on Twitter, for me, a friend would say Twitter has two sides. It has the good side, then the bad side. Because let me say, I one time glanced on a friend's Twitter, and he had two profiles. So one profile was just, let me say, his kind of, let me say, ideal Twitter, the normal Twitter. And the other one was like the crazy, a lot of things Twitter. They're like, oh, the sex Twitter. And I asked him, like, why do you have two accounts? And he's like, oh, sometimes the normal one becomes dull. So sometimes he just changes to the second one, and he was trying to tell me and like, let me see most of the messages that he got on the normal Twitter as compared to like the sexy sassy Twitter handle, the other one that he got, and you could see like the conversations and all that he had. So I was like, wait, seriously, you don't post a lot, you don't tweet, you don't do a lot on your like your normal Twitter, but on your other side, he's kind of like, let me say, sorry to say, he's kind of like just pimping a lot. So I think most people, know, but they are just kind of having like something to just do, and they don't even know what to do again. Yeah.
And then also, I also think what's happening is, yes, people knew, but then there were no videos to back it.
Yeah.
I, for instance, I knew about it, but then I had not seen a video. You know, I had not seen any video. All I knew were just stories and whatnot. But then people now seeing the videos is what's actually like shocked a lot of people. Because yes, they might have heard of it, but then didn't really think it was true. Because these are wild stuff. If someone comes to tell you that, you know what, people go to Dubai to go and eat people's poop, you'll be shocked.
Yeah.
You get it. You know, you'll be having second thoughts. You won't truly believe it. Because you'll be thinking like, what really will make someone want to eat another person's poop? You get it?
Yeah.
So now people now seeing videos, you know, seeing videos and evidences has really shocked a lot of people. I don't think it's because they are surprised about the whole thing, because people actually knew, people have heard of it, just that we had not seen videos. But now we have, and then now people to have come out to, you know, to tell their side of the story, people to have come out to, you know, to confirm and affirm that, well, it is true. When I saw it, I wasn't shocked. But then the video was really nasty, and I didn't want to watch it again. Because sure, these old men. Well,
they are doing things.
That's what happens when they are doing things. People get money and all of a sudden lose themselves. They get money and they forget they are humans.
Yeah.
Because I don't know what would make someone, you know, want to make someone eat, you know, their fecal matter. Even talking about it now, you know.
Yeah,
it's so disgusting.
So I glanced on like they say like 10 like common sexual fetishes, and one was the feet one. I think that's the most common one.
Okay.
Yeah,
the common one, yes.
Yeah, the feet, and the other is the shoe.
And shoe?
Yeah, shoe. So they say for men mostly, this is a fetish. For some women, the heel shoes turn on a lot of guys. While a pretty good shoe done by a man turn on some women. So the idea of having sex with nothing on, except for shoes or heels, is arousing to them. Okay. So that's why, let me say, in blue films, you see people wearing, yeah. And the next one is the ear.
Yeah.
So, the ear. So the thing, I think that's the most like sexual, that drive more of the sexual activities. Yeah. And the color.
Yeah.
So color, so they said the color something found in men. A man see a woman in blue or red and get instantly aroused.
Yeah. So I don't know if I have that. However, I have a thing for women who wear black silky dresses. It arouses me. I don't know if it's a fetish. I don't really think I would classify it as a fetish, but then I find it sexy.
Okay, so the next one, the hair. So the woman in like gorgeous man has proven to be a prime. So women's hair with all the 16 inches and all that. What's the other hair scrap? bone straight and all that. So I think for me, most of them, I think there's this guy at my office, he always, if you're a girl and if you're a woman and your hair is on point, seriously, he just laughs it. And the not so, let me say, stupid one is the underwear. Seriously, with the people who sniff underwear, please, 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 please. Why? 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 Seriously, how can you steal your boyfriend's underwear or your girlfriend's underwear and just be sniffing? Oh no, please.
Yo, that's gross.
Oh.
But then also, I feel like, well, that's someone's fetish. I feel, you know, there are a lot of things that arouses people.
Yeah.
There are things, sometimes there are things that you would not even think of that turns someone on.
Yeah.
You get it? I for instance, well, you know, for me, some of these things, it's not like they arouse me, but then yeah, for me, sometimes there's something that can actually arouse me is a lady wearing a silky, you know, black dress. I find it sexy. But then aside that, one other thing that also, kind of attracts me attracts me to a lady is a lady who has natural hair. I find that also appealing. I find it very cool. But like for me, you know. So yeah, basically, there are things that people do. That reminds me. I read a story on Twitter some time back. I think this was last 2 years, if I'm not mistaken. And it was a man. So a man was working with a firm, and then he said one time a lady selling oranges. Came by, so
yeah.
After buying the oranges, he started talking. This is a married man. He started talking to the lady, and then one thing led to the other. Then he said, after the orange sellers, the body odor, the scent, the scent kind of turns him on. So.
Okay. So I think all is good. And the last one I think I saw was, is it gentrophilia or something? And that's relating to younger girls having that, let me say, obsession with older guys, and older guys having that obsession and all that. So they were just stating like the most common fetishes. So I think this one that I think broke the news everywhere in the world is like the most grossest fetish ever. Seriously.
But have you told the reason why, of all places, this thing takes place in Dubai?
Yeah, because of how their religion is. Because I was reading with a friend, and that friend is a Muslim, and he's like, they have, when he's there, he's out of Dubai, and he said there are some parties that you go. Oh, it has a name. It's like, let me say, a gangbang, but it's not kind of like a gangbang or something. You see a lot of like men in their like 30s, sometimes in their late 20s and all that, having like sex without caring, and mostly it happens like in an unknown location. And he was telling me when this thing came out, he's like, seriously, there are a lot of things going on, and mostly he thinks it's because of their religion, because their religion is too restricted and all that. So I think when they have that kind of experience, they want to experience it more, then they like share it with their friends, they introduce their friends and all that. So for him, he's like for him, he's not shocked. And I think most of his friends there were not shocked, are Asians, they were not shocked. They said, oh, these things happen, they see it, they know it happens. So for him, he was very shocked that Ghanaians, and he's like, nah, even in Africa, it happens. People travel from anywhere. They come as tourists. So it's not surprising. So they should just stop with all that, oh, seriously on Twitter. They should just stop it.
It's nothing new. This thing has been going on for years. People who are into this hookup things, especially the ones that hook up with the big men.
Yeah.
They are very much aware of this. Like, they know.
They know.
These big girls, the slay mamas. For them, they are well aware of these things.
They are very much aware of it. So for me, let me say, it's just something that I'll just say, okay, people are into it. So Delari, I think we'll just end today's show here. I hope everyone liked our fetish, our conversation about it. So you guys can just share us your fetish that you have with you, that you have or you are also into it. So we'll just discuss or anything. So if you like the show, you can always like and subscribe and support us in our description below. The link is there. So with my co-host and my pal, we'd like to say thank you guys very much. See you guys, let me say, this weekend with All Talk. We'll bring you another like sweet conversation to talk about, and hope you guys have fun this weekend. See you all next week. Bye.
Bye. Peace out.